gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, and that weird guy in the third row who secretly wishes the Twilight series wasn't over. Welcome to the laboratory of Professor Slytherin. Before we begin, we would simply like to ask you to please remain in your seats during the show. And please do not touch any of the animals. That last rule about no touching, that includes Professor Slytherin. We don't know where he's been.
Now that that's out of the way, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the smartest man on both sides of the Mississippi River, the best-dressed guest at the slumber party, and the hardest-working scientist in show business, Professor Slithers!
Hey! Woo! I'm gonna pop some tags, only got $20 on my paycheck. Professor Slithers is awesome! How are we doing? Can I see your hat? Okay, welcome everyone. I, of course, am Professor Taryn Slithers. And this is my laboratory. I've invited all of you here to unveil my latest and greatest creation. I have used my studies of chemistry, biology, animal husbandry, wifery, defense against dark arts, Scientology, and Photoshop to create the most glorious, spectacular, photogenic animal in the world. That is right, I said photogenic, but please no pictures until you paid me the $10 photo fee. Slithers is saving for the iPhone 6. Now, prepare yourselves for the most glorious invention of the 21st century! Hang on! It's here somewhere, I'm sure. No! Oh! Mom spelled my name wrong on my tidy whities again. Okay, hold on, just one. It's really awesome. I promise. Isn't it? You're gonna finish these? Later. Okay, this is embarrassing. I promise, it is so lost. What am I gonna do? I worked so hard on it, and now I can't even show it off. How am I supposed to rub it in all of your faces that I'm the best in the world?
Hey, Professor, what's wrong?
Oh, Jess, thank Ryan Reynolds you're here.
Oh, come on, Professor, tell me what's wrong. Use your words. Like a big boy, come on. Take a deep breath. Start from the very beginning, come on. You said hello.
That is it. We will travel around the world. I am so glad that I thought of that.
Professor, I was kidding when I said we should look all over the world for your creation.
Hear this one? She's adorable, right? Right, listen, I'm not kidding. Okay, we have...
Totally awesome!
And I put that in.
I'm sorry, the what?
The Kinetic Matter Transporter 5000!
Totally awesome.
They just said it. Weren't listening?
Nope.
All right. How this works is that everyone here in this laboratory can be transported to anywhere in the world instantaneously. All we need is a little kinetic energy, which, for those of you who do not know, means we need movement.
You know, Professor, that might be the smartest thing I think I've ever heard you say.
I got it. Do I get a treat? You have a treat, right? You have a treat for me?
Yeah, you can get some tactile.
That's good enough for me. Just watch the chia bit.
Now. So, how do we make up the kinetic energy? Is there a treadmill or something?
No. Jess, what is my greatest superpower?
Being wrong about everything, always.
No. I'm gonna get your nose next time.
No, you're not.
My greatest superpower is dancing.
What is love?
I wouldn't call that a superpower, Professor.
Wait till you see my moves. And grand jeté and part of your bra. Now, in order for this to work, we're going to need more than just the two of us to create enough energy. We're going to need some help. How about Charlene comes up here and helps me out?
How do you say your name?
Sharon. Sherry, baby.
All right, this is what I need you to do. When you hear the music start, you start dancing. And when we whip up enough kinetic energy, you will go over with Jess and turn the travel wheel to our destination. Do you think you can handle that? Yeah! And for those of you in the audience, feel free to dance along in your seats. The more kinetic energy, the better.
I think we're ready, Professor.
Me too. It is time to travel the world!
Open Gangnam Style.
Oh my
god. Wow,
what does this mean?
You know, Europe kind of looks like an amusement park.
Why is everyone driving on the wrong side of the road?
Oh, Professor. All right, Sharon, why don't you hop back down in your seat and we'll call you up when we need to travel again.
All right, we need to look for Fluffy.
What?
I named my creation Fluffy.
What does Fluffy look like?
Well, Fluffy looks just...
Oh, Professor!
What was that? Where'd it go? Whoa, Big Bunny!
This is a giant Flemish rabbit.
Does it need a tissue?
No.
Okay.
These guys are found in Flanders, Belgium.
That is where they watch Simpsons and eat waffles.
No, Professor. These guys can get anywhere.
Keep talking.
These guys have a dewlap on the bottom of their chin.
That's where the syrup is.
Actually,
they like waffles.
You're sort of right, Professor. That's
sort of right.
I know. My head hurts.
That's impressive.
It's very fluffy and all, but it's not my fluffy.
All right.
It's fluffy, it's not my fluffy.
Okay. Well, everyone say goodbye to the giant Flemish rabbit.
Bye-bye! Okay, Sharon, it is time to create more kinetic energy. If you just get on the kinetic doohickey thing, let's go. We're there. It is time to again travel the world. So I know I can dance.
Let me go.
All right. Oh, we've arrived in Asia.
Asia. Okay.
You know what? I actually like traveling this way. I don't feel a single bit of jet lag. Or rather, kinetic matter transporter 5000 lag.
I know. I'm
I can't feel
impressed.
The time difference at all.
I'm impressed, Professor. It actually works. So, we got distracted last time. Can you tell me what Fluffy looks like?
Well, Fluffy, remember that one time we saw the thing?
Whoa, Professor, look!
Hello!
It's some phantom silky chickens.
You mean they're ghosts?
No, not phantom. Bantam.
Oh, okay, because he looks scared over there.
Yeah, these guys are small chicken from Asia. And their eggs are really small, too. They're a lot smaller than the ones you find in the grocery store.
Well, that's unfortunate. Can I keep this one?
No.
I want an omelet.
No, Professor. Well, it looks like we're gonna...
It never takes me to Wawa anymore. I'm very hungry. All right. Well, we haven't found food. We haven't found Fluffy. So...
Looks like we gotta go.
I guess we should. Okay, Sharon, it is time to once again create kinetic energy and travel... The world! If only you saw what I could see, you'd understand why I want you so desperately. Right now I'm looking at you and I can't believe you know.
Oh,
you don't know you
show here. This is one of the most glorious natural places in the world. There's so many different types of species here. Man, I wish we could stay here forever, Professor. Professor? Oh, man. This is gonna be good. So, can you tell me what Fluffy looks like?
Okay, well, if I had to describe Fluffy in 7 words or less, the third word
would be... Whoa, Professor, look! It's an African pygmy hedgehog.
What?
An African pygmy hedgehog.
Okay, is it a pig or is it a hedgehog? I'm very confused.
No, Professor. These guys are found in Africa, and they're nocturnal.
Okay, I'm going to stop you right there. I think we can all see that this is clearly not a turtle.
No.
Why would she say that?
No, Professor, not a turtle, nocturnal, which means that they like to come out at night.
That was my second guess.
These guys are also insectivores, which means that they love insects.
Me too! There's one stuck into my back tooth from lunch. Ah.
Ew, yeah. Professor.
Slimy yet satisfying.
You're gross.
I am gross.
When these guys are scared, they'll roll up into a little ball and stick out their quills, which are just hollowed out modified hairs.
So they're not quills, is what you're saying? So that letter I wrote to Hogwarts, there was no ink on that.
Probably should have dipped the ink yourself.
That's Professor. Why I haven't been sorted into Slytherin yet.
So what do you think? Could this be your Fluffy?
It's cute, but it's not as cute as Fluffy. Uh-huh. Like, that's just mean that you'd even think that.
All right, well, everyone say goodbye to the African pygmy hedgehog.
Say goodbye. All right. Sharon, we have not yet found Fluffy, so it is time. You were right. You did it. I taught her everything she knows. Anyway, I think it's time to once again travel the world.
All right. This is Professor Song. This is your jam.
I'd say 9.7, 9.8.
No.
No.
You're in the two regions.
Better. Only souther.
Good job, Professor. So.
You got a treat?
Treats. Yeah, later.
Later. I
got to
treat later.
So, about your Fluffy.
About my Fluffy. Oh, if I could tell stories about that guy. What is this over here?
Oh, Professor, that's a guinea pig.
Is it a guinea pig or is it a hedgehog?
No, Professor, it's a guinea pig. These guys are found in the Andes Mountains.
Okay, who is this Andy? Why does he have a mountain before I do? I just have this little laboratory that I can travel around the world. He has a mountain.
You have a Labradory? So is your laboratory a dog?
She thinks she's funny. Just humor her. It's just, it'll be over soon, I promise.
So
okay.
These guys are common household pets in the United States.
Yeah, those are the ones they put on the sweatshirts, and they sing the songs, and there was that one time they went on that cruise ship.
No,
you remember.
Professor, those are chipmunks. Get it right.
You get it left.
These guys are also really great swimmers, and they can memorize pathways really well.
That's what GPS stands for. Guinea pig.
Super soft.
It's not Fluffy, okay?
Right.
I'm very distraught. So you have to be nice to me. I'm starting to think we're never going to find Fluffy.
Oh, cheer up, Professor. I'm sure we'll find him.
Do you promise? She promised. So we're good.
Well, all right. It looks like the guinea pig's gonna hang out for a little while.
Yeah, guinea pig don't care. All right, Sharon, it is time to again use the kinetic matter transporter 5000 to travel the world.
I won't give up on this. Even if the skies get rough.
Sir,
I'm giving
dance
you
with me.
More.
Oh, come on. I practiced. Oh, it's okay. It's your beautiful smile that really makes me happy. when you're needed. We've arrived in Antarctica, home of the ants.
Ooh, I don't think that's the case, Professor. It's freezing up here.
Yeah, so they just wear tiny parkas and mittens and, that's a lot of mittens because insects have multiple legs.
I don't think Fluffy could be here.
Oh, sure. No. There's this one time we went skiing in Vermont, and oh my goodness, it's freezing.
I don't think anything could live here.
What? Stowaways! They snuck on from Asia! They really like this crack over here.
And they really...
They're cracking their way into show business.
They really don't...
Enjoying the show, are we? You guys aren't shivering at all, are you? In the past life, they all must have been polar bears.
Polar bears don't live in Antarctica, Professor.
Yeah, they live in Coca-Cola commercials. I know. I knew that. All right, are you cold?
I'm freezing.
I'm a little cold.
Let's get out of
the
here.
The world!
Well, I won't give up on us. Even if this...
You're all I have right now. Okay. I lost Fluffy. Happiness comes from within. It's not working. And boomerangs. I was in the glee club in high school. I didn't do much quarterbacking.
Cool story, Professor.
It's in my diary.
Well, there's more from here. Trust me.
Oh, yeah? Like what? Miss Know-It-All Trainer of the Australia.
Like this bearded dragon.
Oh, you know, I've been trying to grow a beard myself. Or maybe a mop, I wouldn't get emotional again.
Dragon.
All right. Sherry, it's time to head home. So let us once more create kinetic energy and travel around the world. Okay. Get in my mojo bag. There it is. Oh.
Enough kinetic energy to travel around the world. Everyone give her a big round of applause.
We went all over the world.
We did?
We didn't find Fluffy. I lost him. I lost my best friend in the whole world, and I can't grow a beard, and I'm just all alone.
Well, Professor, it's okay. Home sometime. Why don't you tell us what he looks like so we all know what to look for?
He's cute and he's cuddly and you just want to give him a big old hug. Yeah.
Professor!
Fluffy! have you lost weight? You're looking good. You started Weight Watchers without me, didn't you? Don't you ever scare me like that again. Do you hear that?
Professor.
It's Fluffy.
I am so happy we found Fluffy, but you know, he sure does look like a rock.
And, well, you look like a roll. I'm over here. Can't get me. Everybody, this is Fluffy. His Rocko's Modern Life. His other favorite cartoon is Hey Arnold. You can't get them all right, I guess. And also, Fluffy, he tells the best rock jokes. Ready? Go ahead, Fluffy! Who's there? This was funny, right? This was Fluffy. Thank you.
Wow, I am so happy we found Fluffy.
I'm so happy, too. I'm so glad that I braved the continents and the unknown for my best pal, Fluffer Nutter. What? Enough already! Okay, get out of here!
You're going the wrong
way! Don't come back! Please bring me an egg McMuffin!
They really love these little pebbles.
Are they fruity pebbles? Because I like those too. But this isn't the time for that!
No!
You almost got it! You did a great job!
Hey, home!
Okay, where were we? Yeah, Photoshop, and then I...
Did what?
I taught everyone in the audience about the various animals we encountered along the way.
Actually, Professor, we...
are in awe of how awesome I am? Yeah, I know. It's simply because I am a genius. Genius. Okay, wait for this one. Are you waiting? Wait a little harder. You're almost there. Genius! Yeah! They increase in number every time. Ladies and gentlemen, you have been a fantastic audience. How about a round of applause for our trainer, Jess? And our volunteer, Jimmy! And me, and Fluffy! There are otter and sea lion shows. I believe otters are 3 and 5 o'clock. Sea lions are 4 o'clock. 4 is not a number. Also, if you stick around at the end of the show, we're bringing out some of the animals. You can pet them. Or you can pet Fluffy! Don't pet me! Look at him! Have a great day at Six Flags!